How many MTA employees does it take to screw in 60,000 energy-saving light bulbs? That's one of the questions I asked Dan Brucker, media relations officer at Grand Central Terminal in New York City.
How many light bulbs have you got here?
Well, here in Grand Central Terminal, we're known for our light bulbs. They're all shown because this was an all-electric train system and building in 1913. We've replaced almost all of them with CFL light bulbs. We are saving literally hundreds of thousands of dollars in money in terms of electricity, but also all the electricity that goes with it.
Grand Central Terminal is the world's largest and busiest transportation hub, spanning 48 acres with foot traffic of over 500,000 people a day. The MTA has been making efforts towards sustainability in some surprising ways.
Your air conditioning is not necessarily that modern, but it is very efficient, right?
It is environmental friendliness defined. Very quickly, here's what it's like. We've always had tons and tons of super hot wet steam in the terminal because there were no buildings built around here, so we were the transfer point for all this hot wet steam. Guess what?
And this steam is made elsewhere in the city by Con Edison, right?
Yeah, and we're a channeling point right for it. But we have no use for it anymore.
So they figured out a way to use hot steam for air conditioning.
We take this super hot wet steam, pump it into these huge vats. But we also pump in something called lithium bromide. It's almost like a salt solution. It takes that super hot wet steam and cools it down so fast that we take that super ice cold agent, pump it through what vents we do have, blow fans over it. Hey, the steam is for free. It exists.
The MTA also recycles tons of newspapers, literally.
So there's never a lack of anything to read in Grand Central Station. There's always a lot of newspapers around to pick up, and then people toss them in these things and they get recycled, right?
As a matter of fact, it is now 5 tons a day, which is the weight of about 4 automobiles. Strange thing happened, because shortly after we introduced it, we were down to 4 tons of newsprint. Guess what? Wall Street tycoons in Armani suits, women in fur coats, were bending over and picking out 1 ton of previously read newsprint.
One of that was me, too, but I'm not a Wall Street tycoon.
Well, I'll tell you this. A newspaper heard about this. It was not the Wall Street Journal, and they were infuriated and told us to put a lid on it. We told them, you put a lid on it. Well, guess what? They paid for these bins, they put these pick-proof lids on it, and they have a contract till time immemorial to maintain these whole things just so their newspapers don't get picked out of these things.
660 commuter trains operate through Grand Central Terminal. Riders might think the diesel fuel alone would emit enough carbon dioxide to make Al Gore produce another documentary. But the MTA is ahead of the game. About 10 years ago, they began using GE Genesis locomotives and switched to ultra-low sulfur diesel fuel 5 years before federal regulations required it.
These locomotives with a 3,200 horsepower engine pulling 6 cars and 600 customers will get what is an amazing, and it really is an amazing, 2.5 to 3 gallons per mile.
From Grand Central Terminal in New York City, I'm Steve Gelsi with MarketWatch.